Welcome back to Pozo Diaries part 4. It's been a little while since the last one, but the last one was a long one, so you have to give me a bit of time to gather the footage together. We have some bad news actually. Since the last time we saw you, Robbie Swift has actually turned up, trained for pretty much a week or so, and he's sustained quite a bad injury to his leg and he's had to fly home. I spoke to Robbie yesterday when he was back in England. He was waiting to go into not surgery but to see the specialist. From what he said is it's broken in three places. He broke his leg actually. I'll just tell you exactly what happened. He went for a one-footed back loop. It was going a little bit wrong and he thought he'd just let go of the kit, just get rid of it and jump off, and his foot actually got stuck in the foot strap and it came up underneath him and he ended up landing on his other leg that was out the foot strap, but all his weight through the one leg, and looking at the first x-rays, it looked like it was broken in three places, once a little bit under the knee and then twice down near the ankle. So we still don't know the full story by that, but I'm sure Robbie will be online at some point to probably tell everyone what's going on. But we wish him a speedy recovery, but it's really unfortunate because Robbie was he's pushing as usual. He was again one of my tips to do well here, and he was sailing good. He had some pretty good doubles when I was watching him that night, the actual night he injured, because I was actually filming, and he had some nice ones, and then I stopped filming and he actually started landing some proper bold dry ones, and he said he'd got something had clicked and he was starting to land them really nicely. It might be the fact that he saw Philip Costa probably do one right in front of him and almost show Robbie how to do a full planing double. If you've never seen a full planing double, check this out. You see Robbie Swift does quite a nice one there, then Costa comes past and just boosts an absolutely perfect planing double. You could even see him looking back at Swift like, yeah, look at that. So even Costa was happy. When Costa's happy with a double, you know it's a good one. So anyway, back to Robbie. So hopefully he's watching this. Robbie, get well soon. If anyone can come back from an injury, it's definitely you, mate. You've definitely got some staying power up there. So good luck with that. If you're feeling a bit down now, which I suppose you are, we're going to cheer you up a little bit. And if you're not cheered up by this, I don't know what will cheer you up. Here is how to warm up for a session, Polish style. Oh yeah. Okay, so that's how you do it. That's how you warm up Polish style. Justine has been giving some tips and maybe that's what I need to do because I've been having a bit of sore arms and shoulders. So we're going to start warming up Polish style. Maybe we'll come back to him for some more tips later on because he's got some moves. And obviously, I haven't mentioned him yet, but the Diaries are still sponsored by the best shop in Pozo. Pozo wins. Actually, maybe they'll sponsor the dance-off this week. But Pozo wins, obviously. If you're only just watching this diary, I'll give you a quick rundown. Best shop in Pozo, I'm voted by Ben Proffitt. They do a lot of cool gear, they rent cars, they sort out accommodation, they do clinics, they teach windsurfing, they pretty much do everything. They repair your sail in a 24-hour turnaround time, and they also re-grip booms. They do everything. So that is the shop to go to if you're in Pozo. Pozo Winds, check them out. The website is on your screens now. So they're still helping us out with the Pozo Diary, so big thanks to them. What else have we seen on the water this week? We've only seen the best dressed man in Pozo. I say best dressed, he's the most color coordinated sailor on the water. He is, of course, Klaas Voggett. He's donning the green. It's a new green look. He's gone for the green sail, he's gone for the green board, he's gone for the green wetsuit, he's gone for the green harness. He looks like a bloody turtle out there, but a very nice looking turtle. So Klaas Voggett, yes, we're locking. See if anyone can beat that. Now that is cooler coordination. Who else have we seen ripping out there this week? We've seen one little nipper. And he is a little nipper. He's 12 years old and he's already busting, you know, little stall forwards. So we've seen him getting some really nice forwards. We've seen him get some wave rides and we've seen him going for the old push loop. He's been catching the mast a little bit, but I don't think it'll be long when he's sailing here nearly every day to get it out. I think he's on a 2.7 sail most of the time and a 53 litre Quattro Custom. So he has all the gear. He is, of course, Nicholas. So keep your eyes peeled for him. We've seen another young guy over in Tenerife, and it's going to be interesting to see how these young guys get on. They are the future of the sport, and it's going to be interesting to see how they get on in a few years. Nicholas is in definitely a place to learn how to jump. And like I said, if the stall forward progression is anything like any of the boys around here, I'm going to be careful next year. I think Costa burst onto the scene at about 12 or 13, so it's going to be interesting. Who else have we seen? We obviously had the big waves last week. A few clips I didn't put in last time. We had pretty much just carnage, just people everywhere. I had one shot, I think it was from BJ Productions actually, Bartek over in Tenerife. He left me some footage and there was some guys dotted around. That was pretty funny to see. And then I also found this clip. Now this is a classic, you don't see this in Pozo very often. And this is Flo Young, who keeper style, trying to get out the wave of a mast high cruncher. Well, he's not quite mast high, but you can see what he's going for there. He was a bit worried. So he did the old ditch the rig in, swim it down. And that just made me laugh when I was looking through, because you just don't see that in Pozo. I mean, I read this technique a long time ago. Robert Trier was explaining how to do it in, I think, a French mag. I couldn't read the words. I just saw the pictures. And I was like, oh, yeah, that's interesting. So I'm going to ramble off on one now. But I had this whole thing in Whitsands in Cape Town. There was a big massive wave coming, just jacked up, mast high, and I'm thinking, oh my god, I know, I'll do the Robert Treaty out, put the rig down. And I went catapult, rig ended up flat, and I'm looking at this wave just going, oh no, wave broke straight on the sail, mast in three pieces, long swim back to the beach. So if you're watching out there, kids, make sure you do like Flo. I don't know if he even did that, but you've got to get the mast down, get the sail like this, so when the wave hits it, it can't get any pressure on the sail. If your wave sail ends up like this, the wave hits it, boom, there you go. That's top tip from Proffitt. Don't do that maneuver. So yes, we've had some big waves in Pozo. What else has been happening? We've had bunker cam. I was going to bring it last week. We were going to be a big feature and we keep going back to it, but I can't. The poor bugger who ended up on the bunker, I can't give him too much because it's pretty hard. There was a lot of guys ending up on there, some of the pros too, but this guy, he was there for a good half hour. So a bit of footage from him. He's looking like he had a horrible time, but he did make it out in the end. Don't worry. Don't feel too sorry. He was okay. Nothing was hurt in the making of that clip. Who else? Little Antoine. Can't go many video diaries without seeing little Antoine. And like I said, floaty jumps, last year now, he's still pulling out the big no first landings. Still not quite got them sorted just yet, as this one pretty much proves.
In no first lander.
So yeah, you can see, we know what he's doing, but bloody hell, they just look dangerous. I'm sure they don't save your board. They look like they're going to break your ankles. And not to be outdone, we have to mention this guy, Ricardo Campello. He's obviously watching the video diaries last week. He saw Philip Costa. What, he just jumps over someone? Is that it? Is that all you got, Costa? Ricardo must have been thinking. Because in this one, I'm just looking through the footage, and you see Ricardo Campello pretty much forward over someone. What are you thinking? The guy's downwind, Rick takes off upwind, he sails over the top of him, and he can see he's looking, thinking, oh god, he goes for the forward, and pretty much if the guy had stopped underneath, he would have cleared him for sure. I would have landed straight on him. Just look at the wake when they land. That is a one close call. So Ricardo Campello, I think you don't see him crash many forwards, so he obviously had one eye on the other guy. But fair play, Ricardo Campello stepping it up. What are we going to see next week? Doubles? Come on, someone's got a double over someone. Actually, no, I shouldn't say that, because we could have all sorts of carnage. Could be dangerous. Also, I got this clip as well. I saw this the other day. Alessio Stirić, I think it's very hard to see who the rider is. I'm pretty sure it's Alessio, but I just caught him coming in. He takes his hand off. He's like, yeah, cruising. And then suddenly he gets this gust of wind. Just boom. boom, straight in. It's a pretty nasty looking wipeout, that one. So he does well to get out. Well, I don't know, he did well to just eject and leave the kit behind him. So let's assume he's just getting out of trouble there, but pretty funny to see. We also spotted one of the big guns of yesteryear, Vidar Jensen. We spotted out there, trained eye, that's what I'm like. Saw him just do a nice backy down by the bunker. He turned up, I think he even chopped his mast up to try and get a small sail. That was last week when it was absolutely cranking. So Vidar Jensen has been spotted out there. Jonas Tobias, I spotted him out the other day. Didn't get much footage of him. Like I said, there's a lot of guys turning up now and it is getting super busy on the water. Alex Mussolini's been flying around doing all sorts of things. He's been doing some real stylish one-footed back loops. But I did capture this guy, not quite doing some stylish one-footed back loops. We could see what he was going for, or was he going for? Maybe I'm just giving him a hard time, but this punter, I think he wanted the one-footed back loop. I know he did. So yeah, that's pretty much what's been going on in the water. Obviously the competition is coming up. We've got sort of 6 days to the start, 5 days to the start of competition. And we've had a few people dropping out, obviously Robbie Swift with that injury. We've got Ross Williams, who's doing, I think, the Formula Worlds. We've got Phil Horrocks, who is his girlfriend's expecting a baby, so I don't think Phil's going to come. And we've got one other missing person, Cowley Ciardi, who's sunning it up on some boat in Brazil, checking out the spots. Poor Cowley. So we've got four guys missing. That means four more guys get into the competition without having to do the trials. So by my calculations, that should be the next four. So it's Omar Sanchez is in the main comp now. We got Klein Gant, who's in the main comp. We got Little Antoine, who's in the main comp. And then there's a controversial one. I'm not going to say too much about it, but at the moment it's Bougemar in it because he was injured. And a few people saying it should be Alessio because he's actually next in the list. So that debate, I think, will go on, and it's going to be interesting to see which way it goes. But some people I've spoke to think Booz should get one of the trials places because he was injured and it shouldn't be taken away from Alessio. That's up to the PWA to decide and those boys to sort it out. But the comp is coming up, and we are ready. Trust me, we've seen some big moves going down the last week. Push forwards, we've got everything. I've got a collection from BJ Productions, obviously it's Bartek in Tenerife, who's given me some stuff from Costa. We've got some stuff from Alessio. I'm going to put that in the next one. But we do have a pretty cool wipeout section, which I'm going to play for you now. This, I've just sticked some odd music to it, and you just check out the wipeouts from last week. These are sweet. So that is how to wipe out Pozo style. I mean, Christ. And you know how to warm up Pozo style, don't you? So that's how to warm up. You know how to do it now. So if you want to warm up, the best thing to do, this saves you getting injured. You see them boys crashing, you've got to warm up before you crash like that. And if you're fed up of crashing like that, you're having a bit of struggle with your forwards, you know where you need to come? Pozo wins. That's what you've got to do. Get yourself in on a clinic. Learn to loop in 2 days. Josef Pons, our resident guru at Pozo Wins, has been teaching these boys, and they are touching 50, learning to loop for the first time they've tried in 2 days. I'm going to leave you with this video. Just check the progression and get yourself booked onto a clinic. Now that's how to do it. We'll see you in a couple of days for the next Pozo Diaries.
Oh la la.
Push the tempo, 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 push the tempo. We'll be right back.
I've never tried forward in my life before.
Really?
Yesterday I had maybe 10 attempts. Just to have the guts to try. I was
good.
Quite satisfied.